Video arcades are where it all started, so there's nothing better than being able to play the classic games on your PC. But MAME ROMs can be confusing and awkward to get working. Let me show you what it's all about. Hi and welcome to Bytes and Bits. If you want to play arcade games on your computer, you'll need to use the MAME emulator. Now you can either download this as a standalone program, or you can use it from within one of your front-end emulator systems such as RetroPie or Launchbox. Getting the MAME software installed and running is very straightforward. You just install the downloaded software, or you can enable the emulator core and you're all set to go. And please check out my arcade emulation tutorial for full details on how to do this. But when it comes to getting games working, it can be a bit tricky and very confusing. MAME ROMs don't work the same way as other emulators. To get a game to work, you need a few different files, and it's not always obvious which ones you need. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how MAME ROMs work, what you need to get games working, and where you can download the files that you need. So to understand MAME ROMs, we first need to understand how an emulator works. So an emulator is a piece of software that runs on your computer or your laptop, and that simulates the hardware of some other computer system, for example, an arcade cabinet or a games console. The hardware of the computer you're trying to emulate consists of several electronic circuit boards with various microprocessors and support chips, which are in turn connected to the controls, the speakers, and the display. And the emulator software must model each of these processors and support chips in software. Now, once that's all being emulated, we can then use a copy of some original game software, and that will run as if it were actually working on the real computer hardware. Now, for most games consoles and home computers, the electronics inside of the box didn't change for different games. So emulators for these systems know which microprocessors and support chips they need to emulate. The emulator can be built around this specification and needing only the game software to change to allow you to play all the games for that system. Now, arcade cabinets are a bit different. Quite often specialised cabinets were built for specific games. And once that cabinet was built for one game, then it would be reused for a number of other games, with possibly a few modifications to the internal workings. So arcade cabinets also tended to have more complicated circuits, having multiple processors handling different parts of the system. And the MAME emulator must be able to account for all these differences and put these together in the correct combination of processors and associated circuitry for each cabinet, and that's before it can then start to run the game software. Now, MAME ROMs are therefore split up into several different types. And as well as the actual game software ROMs, you'll also need some device ROMs, which are the bits that simulate the different parts of the arcade cabinet, and BIOS ROMs, which contain the system software for specific circuit boards. So multiple ROM files are required to run a single MAME game. And this collection of files forms what's known as a ROM set. So what are these ROM sets then? Well, an individual ROM file is simply a dump of the information stored in a read-only memory chip on a circuit board. It contains the software that drives that component of the computer system. And as we've seen in the previous section, an arcade cabinet needs a number of these pieces of software together with the hardware emulators to run any arcade cabinet. So a MAME ROM set simply gathers all the files required to simulate a game into a single archive file. When you load the game into MAME, it knows which files it needs to emulate that arcade cabinet, and it then loads these and looks for these ROM files in this archive ROM set. So to get any game working in MAME, you need a complete ROM set. So there are a number of different types of ROM sets that you can get for MAME. And one of these are split ROM sets. So although arcade cabinets were often specialised to a specific game, they were of course reused for other games, and many of the circuit boards were built in a modular fashion so that parts could be swapped in and out to customise the system. This does mean though that there are a lot of common parts between different games. So when arcade machine emulation started back in the 1990s, computer storage was expensive, so reducing the amount of data you had to store was particularly important. Now, as you've just seen, a lot of the files needed to run a game on a particular cabinet were duplicated then. And these then were duplicated across these ROM set files. And this is where the concept of a split ROM was developed, to stop this unnecessary duplication. Parents and clones of arcade games can be grouped together based on original cabinets that they were developed for. The game that ran on the original cabinet can be thought of as the parent of all the games that were then developed using that same cabinet. These child games then are termed clones in the MAME system. So a parent ROM set contains all the files that are common to both the parent and the clones of that arcade cabinet. It also contains the parent game files which allow that game to run. Clone ROM sets only contain the specific files needed for that particular clone, along with the actual game software itself. So a clone ROM set can't run without the parent ROM set. And this system using the parent and ROM sets is called the split ROM set. So we also have BIOS and device ROM sets. So most of the files required to run a game are contained in the parent and clone ROM sets. But most systems also require BIOS and device ROM sets to completely emulate any particular arcade cabinet. So different parent games may use different arcade cabinets, but again, several of the components are common across a number of these systems. So these common component files are again split out from the full ROM set files into these separate files for both the BIOS and the device ROM sets. So another type of ROM set we'll find are merged ROM sets. Now, if you've managed to follow along with this so far, you'll understand that any single arcade game requires a parent ROM set and its clone ROM set, and that games can be grouped together by their parents. Now, the MAME emulator finds files by first looking in the ROM set that you ask it to emulate, and then if it can't find some of the files, it then checks to see if there is a parent ROM set. Now, the thinking behind a merged ROM set is that if MAME expects to find the files it needs in the ROM set that you ask it to run, then why not put all of the files for all of the games for a particular group into one single ROM set? And this ROM set then will emulate the parent ROM set files and every single clone that was developed using it. When you then ask MAME to run a game, it will have every file it needs in this single multi-game ROM set. So a merged ROM set file lets you run a parent game and every single one of its clones. Now, just to add one more layer of complexity to MAME, it also uses something called CHD files. Now, new arcade machines didn't have all the software built into ROM chips on the circuit boards. Like modern computers, they had hard disks, DVD drives, CD drives, and in some cases, laser disks. And the data stored on these types of media tends to be large. So MAME uses a different file format to compress and store this data. And these are the compressed hunks of data files, or these CHD files. So on top of the various ROM set files that you may need, you also may need some CHD files to get a game to work. So which ROM set files are the best ones to use? Well, there isn't really a right or wrong answer. If you're downloading individual games, you'll most likely be downloading split ROM sets. So your games won't run until you've also downloaded any other ROM set files that this particular one depends on. And this can sometimes be an awkward process, and you can spend a lot of time trying to piece together the files that you need to get any game working. Merged ROM set files will give you a group of games in one go with all the associated ROM files so that you can have a better chance of getting the game you want to work. Now, my advice for the easiest way to get your arcade games up and running is to actually download what's known as a reference set. And these are downloads that contain all of the ROM set files for all of the arcade games that MAME supports. Now, this can actually be a very big download, and this is upwards of 50 gigabytes for just the ROM files. And that's ignoring any of these CHD files, which in themselves can be quite massive downloads. But you do get everything you need to start playing your games in one go. Now, once you start looking at MAME downloads, you'll find that there are a large number of versions. And this is another confusing part of the MAME system. The MAME emulator is continuously being updated to improve compatibility and expand the number of games that can be emulated. So with each new version of MAME, some of the ROM files are updated. So perhaps a better version of the ROM file image is created, either errors are fixed, or there's a new version that just simply requires some modifications. But whatever the reason, it means that not all ROM set files will work with all versions of MAME. Now, usually a reference set is created each time that a new version of MAME is released. And my best advice is to always use the reference set that matches with the version of MAME that you're going to be using. You can mix versions, but sometimes you'll find that the games just won't work. Now, if you're using a standalone version of MAME, you already know what version you're using. But if you're using something like RetroPie or Launchbox, you'll probably need to use the correct version of MAME that works with your libretto core or whatever it is you're using. And you'll be able to find these by doing a bit of a Google search. So the big question is where is the best place to get hold of these MAME ROMs? So as with any ROM download, you'll need to have a search around to find the ones that you want. Now, MU Paradise, and I've given a few tutorials on here on how to get those links working, it has a great archive, but it can be a bit hit and miss depending on which version of MAME you're running. As I've already mentioned, my advice is to download a full reference set. And I find that the best place to get hold of these is at archive.org. If you just head over there and search for the MAME followed by the version number that you want. For example, I needed some MAME ROMs for my RetroPie installation, where I was using the libretto core for MAME 2003. And this requires the 0.78 version of MAME. So searching for this on archive.org gives a few options. For each of these downloads, there are a number of options on how you can actually do the download itself. But I found the best way is to use BitTorrent. And this will hopefully decrease your download time from a couple of days. And yes, if you're downloading it over the normal HTML channel, it can take a few days to get this 50 gigabyte file down. And it should take it down to a few hours. Now, if you haven't used BitTorrent before, it allows the community to supply the files that you need. But it does this in a safe environment where it keeps tabs to ensure that the files that you're downloading are valid and untampered with. And again, I'll put some links in the description down below so you can find out more about how BitTorrent works. Now, if you have been downloading individual games or using a reference set that doesn't match your MAME version, you might get errors messages whenever you try to run a game. And it can be hard to work out which ROM set you need to download to fix these errors. So the arcade database, and again I'll put links down below, this can be a great help in trying to work out what's going on. So if you search for the game you're having trouble with, you'll find a page which gives you all the information about that specific ROM set, along with which parent ROM set that belongs to, and then which platform ROM sets and BIOS and devices you need to get it all to run. From there you can start working out which other ROM sets your game ROM set depends on. So hopefully you now understand everything about MAME ROMs and the ROM sets. The only thing left to do is to install MAME, download a reference set, and start playing. So hopefully you found this video useful. If you have, please do click on that subscribe button and turn on your notifications to make sure that you get easy access to all of my new videos. So have fun playing your arcade games. Hopefully I'll see you in another video soon, and bye for now.
For more games programming, electronics projects, and retro gaming, please make sure you like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and visit my website.